Yeah, I was pretty pleased. I thought the first quarter was a pretty scrappy quarter from both sides, and I suppose we just grind our way back into the game, and I think we had to think our way through, you know, with the spares and how to work the footy. I thought our group adjusted pretty well, and yeah, to win by that much, I was ecstatic at the end. You know, sometimes when you look at, you know, going into a game and you have I suppose your captain out, and you see who takes up the responsibility and who digs in a little bit deeper. And I thought, especially for our midfield, I thought, you know, it was fantastic. Stevens, Gibbs, Murphy, I thought everyone took up the slack. Grigg in there, Bentick, I thought it was fantastic across the board. Yeah, I think it was pretty pleasing that, I suppose, you know, everyone thinks that Fev has to kick 6, 7 or 8 to win as well. So no, Judd and Fev kicks 4 and we sort of win by around 4.5 goals. I thought it was very pleasing. Yeah, I could, yeah. I think our last quarters have been outstanding. Probably about the last month, and we've given teams a head start and wheeled them in or really closed the gap pretty quickly. So yeah, I think the boys' belief in themselves and their teammates to run out games is just increasing every time we do it. Yeah, I thought, I suppose Richmond like to play a counter-attack game and put spares behind, as they did to Port Adelaide, and outrun them. And you know, I suppose you've seen that with Bowden last week with around 39 possessions or something. They like that so they can get overlap and run into their game. I think that they got off to a flyer with that. But then as the game sort of closed down and we sort of got the momentum back in our game and we sort of got the ball in our hands, but there's a lot of errors in that first quarter. Missed kicks, players out by 15 metres, or you know, kicks dropping in front or over their head. I think both teams had that, which was not pretty to watch. Yeah, I think we've seen Nick do that through the year, but I suppose with Chris out, it really highlighted his impact on the game, and you know, we'd send messages down and everything would get done. He'd just orchestrate it and organise players to get the situation that we needed. He was outstanding. Well, I suppose I spoke on, I think it was Wednesday, and said it was a defining game for both teams for the season. And, you know, I suppose one team would gain a lot of confidence and one team would lose a lot of confidence. And I suppose with Chris out, you know, I suppose we put that out yesterday because that would put a little bit more pressure on Richmond, you know, thinking, oh, well, maybe they come a little bit complacent. I don't think they did, but to our boys' credit, they took that slack up and really responded well. Well, we seem to. I think we've got confidence in our ability to play some good footy, but I think we've seen some of the work that we can do as well, and that's up and down. You know, last week we didn't come to play last week at all in that first quarter, and I think that that showed in the game. And the week before we beat Collingwood, and we need to string wins together, and that's our next challenge, to get sort of, you know, the 2 and 3 wins together. At the moment, we're just trying to now win against St Kilda, who's our next challenge. We get a bit of a look at them, but yeah, we need to make sure we get consistency in our performance.
No
effort? No, I said it once and I'm not saying. We need to work on the process of winning games, and winning 2 games in a row would be a fantastic start for us. I thought, until Richo went off, I thought he played an outstanding game on Richo. I thought he was, you know, pressed up, and you know, he's a great player, Matthew Richardson, to run as well as he does at his age, and just to keep belting up and down and to play forward and around the midfield. He's a great athlete. Well, I believe we would have ran over the top of him anyway, but what it did allow us to do is say, well, we'll put Jared Waite forward, and you know, because they seem to keep going a lot smaller in their front half, so we had to restructure a little bit there. So as soon as they did that, we could just allow our defenders to sit at home, take all comers, and Jared go forward to put a little bit of pressure on them, which did allow Wiggins and Fisher to sort of jump out of the loop as well. I think we always learn about, you know, the way we play and things like that. The great thing, I suppose, we've reduced the amount of ball we went to Brendan by a little bit, but I think it was great for other players' confidence to be used a bit more and have that opportunity to score, and we did that. So yeah, it was pretty pleasing. I suppose it depends what the opposition's tactics are as well. You know, sometimes you can allow to play with an open forward line. Sometimes, you know, I dare say St Kilda will have, as I've watched them over previous times against us and against Fremantle last week, they'll have every person they can back in front of our forwards, regardless if it's Brendan or anyone else. So that'll be our next challenge.